okay, it's time to do this.
So this is my first ever guitar building project. I've got this body and neck at a local flea market, and I paid around $70 for it. So it was pretty cheap. I have no idea what brand it is or what type of wood. I don't know much about this, but you can follow me on this journey to learn and try to build a cool guitar. So what am I gonna do first? I have to check that my pickups will fit in here, and I've decided to go with the EMG pickups active because I don't have any guitars with EMG, and they're pretty known for being metal pickups. So I have the 81 in the bridge and the 85 in the neck. So I'll have one here and one here. So let's open and see if it will fit. So yeah, I knew they looked like this. So I will have one here and this will fit here. But here I have to cut out the wood to make room for it. So that will be my first mission. So I need a wood cutter thingy. I don't even know what that's called in English, but I know that my cousin have got a hold of one, and I'm gonna go down to him, and we both don't know what we're doing. So yeah, follow me down and let's see how we make this disappear. Okay, it's try and fail. Let's try this on a piece of wood first. Safety glasses, no go. Let's try a bigger drill. Yeah, the other side. Yeah. There's enough room here for one more pickup, at least. Right, it's time to put some filler in. I'm gonna fill in some of these small screw holes and my little mistake there. I don't think I'll do anything in the back, just yeah, make it smooth. Okay, never done that before, so I'll let this dry for 20-30 minutes and try to sand it off and see if I have to do it one more time. Yep. Okay, so it's been 30 minutes. I'm gonna take some, what's it called, grit or sandpaper and try to make it smooth. Alright, now I will go over this with an almost dry cloth and just get all the dust and stuff off it. Okay. That's good. I'll leave it to dry overnight and continue tomorrow. Day two. So I'm gonna paint the top of the neck. So I've masked almost all the way down. And I've also masked in here. So now I'm gonna hang it up on my green screen setup and just use some rope and tie it up. That should work. Primer. Okay, I think I'll let this dry for about an hour and then I'll give it another go. Let's go round two. Okay, that will do, but I think I have some sanding to do here. Definitely. Alright, I'm gonna sand it down a bit now. Sand it, that's probably not the right word. I have this. It's 180. That doesn't mean anything to me, except that it's a pretty light sand, so try to get away all the little fragments. So I'm gonna do this outside the studio just to not get a lot of crap in there, so let's go. Okay, so that was the wrong paper. This was the one I was gonna use. It's 400. Yeah, so I gotta be very light on the hand, or else I'm gonna just take away all my work. So maybe I shouldn't have put on my most expensive pants. Okay, I'll just dry this off, and maybe it's ready for color soon. Okay. I've hung them up again. I found out that it's better to put it this way so I don't get the string here, because I had a little problem I had to fill in here afterwards. And the same goes here really, but I just have to fill in when I take off the string again. Alright, I'm gonna do a white layer first and then take it from there. Yeah, I'll let this dry for an hour or two, and then I'll do another layer. Okay, I've done two layers of white, so now I think I'm gonna sand it just a little bit, and then start with the texture. Hello! So now I'm gonna take my Frog Leap logo in two different sizes, print them out, and cut them out with the scissors and try to incorporate the logo to my guitar. There it is. I'm in the basement again. Sorry for all the noise, but my wife just put on the washing machine. So I found this crazy guy on YouTube.
1, 2, 3.
Fire! And he did a great thing with some texture that I wanted to try. So I bought in some gray and black spray. And I also have a little bit of the white left. So I'm going to try something with some newspaper stuff. Fingers crossed. Girl, look at that body. Girl, look at that body. Girl, look at that body. That was pretty nerve-wracking. I think I'll just stop here and just keep it like that and just clear coat it, and the finish is done. Okay, it's the last step of the finish, so I'm gonna take some clear coat and just make it shiny. It's dripping.
So I probably did every mistake you can do, so please don't kill me in the comment sections, you guys who knows what you're doing. But it's just fun to do it all by yourself and just try. And I can see some potential here.
Alright, so I put three layers of clear coat on it now. So I've heard it should dry for about a week before I fine sand it down. So I'm gonna do some work on the neck while I'm waiting for the last touch on that. And I have a guy coming to just show me some tricks on how to level frets and all this stuff. So yeah. So there is some glue and dirt on this neck, and some small fraction of something there. So I'm just gonna take some fretboard oil cleaning stuff and try to get this off. This is the worst working table ever. It's a camping table that I bought a couple years ago, and it sucks. Okay, so now we're checking the levels of the fret. Jacek here was showing me how you do this with this tool here. What's it called?
A fret rocker.
Fret rocker.
So you just put it over the frets. And here you can hear it's not totally in level. You can hear that rocking sound, and that means that they're not the same height all over. But this neck is pretty good, so I don't think I will do the work on it. I'll just see how it turns out when I put everything together, and if I wanna, or I maybe get him to change out the frets, maybe do some bigger ones, but I'll leave it for there now. But we're gonna we're gonna sand down some of these edges up here, because some of them, not a lot, is quite pointy, so I just wanna sand them down. Okay, so I learned quite a lot about the fret board work, but yeah, this is pretty, it's pretty good. But I'm gonna put this, the nut on here, but it's a little big, so I have to sand it down a bit to make it fit in here, so let's do it. I'm just gonna take a small bit of super glue to glue this down. I've heard people not recommending this, and I've heard people recommending this, but I think the clue is not to take too much, just to make it just stick a little bit, because your strings will hold them down anyway, so let's try. Okay, I felt like I have done a lot in 2 days, and I just want to finish it. I have to talk to my brother and get some help with the pick board, that's what it's called. And yeah, and then it's just the mounting left, I think. Some polishing and maybe some other stuff. But let's go to the next day. Okay, I'm in my brother-in-law's garage, because I have to cut a bigger hole in these, because the locking tuners don't go in yet, and I don't have much gear at home to do this, so yeah, I have my dad here with me to help me. Let's do it. Just testing, we need a small hole for this to push it in also. So we need one big, one small.
Ah, men det ikke så godt. Jeg skulle låse den fast, for det blev sådan blød. Okay,
I'm a holder now.
Just gonna lock it off here with a piece of wood, because yeah,
I don't bother to have the arm to do crazy stuff, just make it easy for myself. So I was planning to do everything myself, but when I'm with him, he has to do everything, so all right.
Okay, I'm gonna draw out the pick guard the custom pickguard here on a piece of paper, get all the measurements right, and then use it as a template for the plastic cutout.
Okay, I'm gonna do some work in the house because she's watching TV there. I'm gonna sand this down now with some wet sanding, I think it's called. And I'm gonna use some water and just try to straighten everything out before I polish.
Alright, so now I'm gonna try something I've never done before. What's it called? Polish? So I have this. I probably should have locked this off, but yeah, let's just try. Good morning, I'm here at Chrisma Plastic, and I'm getting some help to scan in the pick board and drawing it up nicely and then print it in some sort of plastic. Yes, I think I should have all the pieces now, so I'm gonna start to put it all together and hope I can do it all by myself without any help. But let's see, I'm gonna start with these, the locking tuners. Wish me luck. Okay, so this is hopefully the last day of the guitar build, and I'm getting some help with some soldering, that's what it's called. I bought some new wires because the EMG pickups are, you don't need to, what's it called, soil them, it's just plug in, but for the
switch of the guitar, I need to do some soldering. So I've got the plates that I made at the plastic factory, and I've also sanded down the edges a bit to get a little more smoothness on the edge. And I've also put in the pickups in the front. So yeah, I'm awaiting Jacek now, and looking forward to getting this done. Coffee is needed. I'm a bit hungover because I was at a wedding yesterday, but okay. Okay, the first problem is that these screws from the bridge don't get any tension on the pre-drilled holes, so we need to put some toothpicks in before we make the holes for everything, but it should work. Yes. Okay, so I put a coin in there, and this, I had to sand this for a very long time to get it to fit, but now it's stuck on. So I think I can put the plate on like this. I finally get to use this thing that's been standing in the studio for some years.
Son.
We have some problem with the connections here because it's a wire mess. But when we followed the diagram, it worked out. But now I'm eating spaghetti, and we're eating spaghetti.
And he's soldering.
Okay, we're gonna attach the battery here. So I bought this little angle, and Jacek had an idea doing this because there's not a lot to go on with this.
Well, oh, that's more than enough.
Okay.
Whoa. Vänta lite, får du ta ner på? Sån ja. Då borde säkert edita lite.
Ja, ja.
Like this, yes.
Yes. He just said how good I was at doing this.
It didn't fit, Leo.
No, no. Okay, last plate. Dun, 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 dun. We need to take off this yellow thing because it bothers
the sponge,
me.
The sponge thing.
Yeah, the sponge thing. It's bothering me. I can feel it. Yeah, it's still there. The last screw. Hopefully. First try.
So I'm really happy right now. It turned out way better than I would have thought at the start. I think it looks great and it feels great to play. The strings are really nice to the neck and everything is in order. So yeah, it's just a pleasure to play it. So I think I'm gonna have this guitar in a drop C tuning because I have a lot of guitars in standard E or drop D. And I have some baritones who are in B or drop A. So I want a middle ground. So I put 11 to 54 on here. So they're pretty heavy gauge strings. So I'm lucky enough to have friends and people I know who know about this stuff. So as you saw, I didn't do everything myself, but I was involved with everything and had a little help sometimes. Mostly just asking people what to do, so just to spare some time on looking everything up on YouTube or the internet. So things went really fast, so I'm really happy. Thanks to everyone who was involved. I think this pickguard turned out really good. I was primarily thinking to having a black one, but when I designed it, I thought the shape was a bit funny. But now when it's see-through, it just looks really good, I think. And you can also see all the wires, so it got more of that I've made in myself homemade look. And yeah, I'm just really happy about the whole design of it. And since these EMG pickups are active, it means they need to have a battery that you need to change sometimes. So I made a split in the pickguard here, so I can easily just screw out this bit and change the battery when I need it. Then I don't have to take off all of this and maybe strings and yeah. So that's an easy solution and just a little split there.
So I decided to go just for a volume and a three-way switch. I didn't want the tone knob because I never use it and I sometimes accidentally hit it and it turns and I record half a song with it like this and I suddenly realized that my sound sucks. So yeah, no tone up.
And the three-way switch is in this position. It's the bridge. In the middle, it's both. And the top is the neck pickup. So, yeah, easy and good.
So, what did I learn? A lot of things, really. About the sanding, you need to take your time and spend hours if you want it really, really smooth. There are some flaws here. You can see the grain from the paper, but I think since it's textured like this, it don't need to be like silky smooth like my Musil guitar back there, which is really, really nice in the finish. This is more rough-like. Another thing is, when you buy in all the parts before you start on anything, the finish, just make sure everything fits and you have a plan on how to do it. Because after I put on everything finished, then I started fitting the things on, and there was things that needed to be done, like making bigger holes in here and doing some stuff in here, and yeah. And then you can mess up your finish if you need to go back and alternate the shape of the guitar. So yeah, be as prepared as you can before you start. So is it cheaper to build your own guitar and buy the parts or buy a brand new one? I ended up a pretty high price, but I definitely think you can, if you know what you're doing, you can definitely save some money. But of course it takes many hours to build it, so you have to decide for yourself if it's worth it. I ended up around a little over $600, so that's quite a lot. So we can see here, on the body and neck, I spent $70 just on the wood here and here. And the pickups, $235. So that's quite a lot. The knobs and the wires and stuff, around $140. The bridge, I only spent around $10. I bought it used. So that was a bargain. But for the paint, the spray and the sand and all that, I spent $175. And I could definitely get that a lot cheaper if I went another place. I just went to a paint store, like, what do you call it, a high-end paint store, and just came in there like, I don't know anything, I need something to do this. And they probably just looked at me like, okay, take the most expensive of this one, the most expensive of this. So I could probably just half that price if you're a little smarter than me. All in all, just so happy with the result. I have my own custom Frog Leap guitar made by myself. And the name is Mr. Frog. See you later.